Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now, today I want to talk about how to decide which features to make free versus paid. Okay, so today I want to answer a question that came in from video 291, once again from Spencer Deppas. Thanks, Spencer. I appreciate all the questions that you send through. He said, "Hi, Eric, how do you decide what features you make free versus paid?" Now, I'm going to preface this again with I'm not an expert, and a lot of times, I hate to say it, I just sort of wing it in the past. But I'm going to tell you what has worked for me, what works the best for me in my apps now, and what hasn't. So first of all, let's just say a little bit about in-app purchases. I have a very low conversion rate for in-app purchases. I mean, it's pretty good because I get revenue coming in. So it's, you know, we've gone through my revenue and a lot of it comes through in-app purchases. But I once had this, like, back in the early, this is like 2014, I was talking to this guy who was like this app guru, and he had he did seminars and stuff like that. And he was saying, like, "Well, you should expect about a 20% conversion rate on in-app purchases." And I have never come anywhere close to that, nor have I ever spoken to another app developer who has. So usually the in-app purchases, it's usually about 1% or less. So most people will download the application and they won't do an in-app purchase. So that's why you have to be able to add value to it. So I just want to put that out there. And by the way, in the app world, you're going to get this a lot. You get a lot of people who try to sell you on their seminars and their books or whatever. But when you actually ask to see their numbers, they can't really produce. So it's just something to look out for. And I've fallen victim to that before. When you start listening to, you get advice from people who don't really know. So I'm going to say right now that I am not an expert. Now, my biggest app, which is EarSpy, EarAssist, on Android, we have 4 in-app purchases. We have remove ads, MP3 recording, home screen widget, and extended equalizer. And of all of those, extended equalizer does the best. So let's just walk through some of them and talk about how they work. First of all, your in-app purchases should always complement the app. Like if the app was used on its own without them making the purchase, it should still provide value for the user. Like years ago, I read this article and I wish I could remember where I'd read it, but they said that you could charge most for applications which increase the value of the phone. So you know, your users are spending all this money on their new smartphone. They really like it and everything. So if you could do something that, in terms of like a utility app that adds value to that phone. So for me, you know, the EarSpy thing was, it gives you super hearing, or like Shazam would be, you can listen to any song or whatever. Then you can charge a little bit more for that. So based on that, remove ads in-app purchase has never really done well for me. So a lot of the applications we did, like, you know, I wasn't really sure what to do with it. So I didn't want to limit the value of the application. I wanted people to use it and I wanted people to like it. Like a lot of us do, is that I don't want to annoy my users. So I put ads in, and the only in-app purchase was to remove ads, and that never does well, right? It just doesn't convert very well unless somebody uses it all the time. So, and that's just my experience. And when you think about it, like, you probably at the beginning of this video, you probably saw an ad, you know. But if YouTube had said, if you just pay $5 a month, you don't have to see any ads. Most people would not go for that. I mean, some people would, I probably would, but most people would say, "Nah, you know, I got the same user experience as everybody else. I just click skip ads, it's fine, it's not that big a deal." So, and it's the same with apps. I'm finding that a lot of the times that one in-app purchase for remove ads doesn't convert really well. If you're having a different experience with that, please let me know, because, you know, obviously maybe I'm not putting enough ads in there, but you know what? I think I'm putting plenty in. So the other in-app purchases are MP3 recording. That does okay. That's probably does the second best. Home screen widget. Nobody wants a home screen widget. It was just sort of this thing that we're dreaming up stuff that we can add. What can we put in there? And we thought, we'll put that in there, but we'll make it as part of the in-app purchase. So, and that was one of the early ones, you know, and it's not really all that useful a feature. It doesn't add to the experience at all. It's just a thing. Some people, I think the people who buy it are the people who just want to have the whole set of stuff, which is fine by me. And then the last one is the extended equalizer. So just to give you a little bit of background, the application, what it is it has a, you just listen, it takes the audio from the microphone, goes straight to the headset, and you got a graphic equalizer where you can adjust it, so try to filter out background noise and stuff like that. So a lot of the things when the later versions of Android came out, they'll add stuff like echo cancellation, bass boost, extra equalizer, bars and stuff like that, depending on the phone, right? When that stuff comes out, we put it in as an extended equalizer function. So that's the one that converts the best. That probably gets, I should show you the numbers, but it's a lot more than the others. It's probably, you know, 3 or 4 times more than the other in-app purchases are doing combined, because that actually increases the value of the application. If they like the experience of the app, then that adds to the core of it. But if you only have the basics of it, then it, you know, it's still a usable application, and still a lot of the ad revenue comes from that. So as much as, and with ads, in-app purchases are, I think they're a lot better than ads. If you can get people using in-app purchases, you know, ads, everyone's annoyed by ads. You need to have a lot of downloads for those that actually make a decent amount of money, and you're at the whims of the ad mob, advertiser revenue, all that kind of stuff. If you have something that really converts well with in-app purchases, and you know, ours on that application, I think they do pretty well, but there's not the 20% that the app guru told me about. So anyway, Spencer, I'm just telling you where I am with that. Every time we add a new application, I always try to do something where we, rather than just remove ads, have something that adds to the experience. So again, we also have the language games. So the language games would be like, we have like 60 lessons in it, so 60 modules, and we make the first 10 free because it just sort of, if they, so they can still use those first 10, they can still use it enough to leave a good review, they still could get some value out of it, but if they really like it, then they can get the full thing with one non-consumable purchase. And we tried to do like selling each module individually, that didn't do very well either. It's better just to do one flat out purchase to do the whole thing. So that's just been my experience. Some of you guys out there are gonna have a much better experience than I have with this kind of stuff, so please put in the comments what works best for you, you know, and what kind of conversion techniques you have there and everything like that. My goal one day, and it's just because I'm so lazy, I wanted to have consumable purchase so people can buy in-app currency like coins and stuff like that, which they could be rewarded with rewarded video ads, and also, and just buy them outright. That's where I wanted to go, but we haven't done that yet with any of them. So anyway, so that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.